smelter with me. And blacksmith. Oh, I already had a blacksmith bench here. Oops. My bad. I don't really need another one unless I want to fully dedicate it to reinforcement production. But apparently this statue is here that I had misplaced earlier. Why are you not stacked with the rest of the aloe that I left behind? That's why. I made some aloe, but I did not take it with me. Yikes. Well, hopefully that won't bite us in the ass later. And it's layered silk is here, like I expected. Some gossamer with me. Some silver bars. I can turn into coins. I think the giant has the carpenter's bench. And a folded bed. And we want the carpenter's bench to be on the first floor. Like so. Not quite centered, but good enough. The bed will place next to this central pillar, where it will hopefully not take too much space. And we'll leave you here for now. Do you have anything in your inventory that I really need? I could get started with some of those black ice thingies. So foundations. Not this expensive. Yeah, I need more black ice. But yeah, foundations we need. Is it 18 or 24? Let's make 18. Six on this ring, six on this, and 12 on the one outermost. So 22, not 18. You basically just replace these with it. Also, we don't get our resources back from these foundations unless we demolish them first, but if we demolish them, then they might cause disturbances in calculating the structural integrity of this tower by suddenly altering the way it calculates the path from foundational support. And that might break some ceiling pieces, and we can't really demolish these foundations under a workstation, because then the workstation will be destroyed, but we can possibly place a foundation on top of a foundation just to upgrade it that way. Is a foundation piece, or is it? Yeah, it is, because it's attached to this wedge. It has to be a normal foundation. So that's all of these, because we're missing maybe something. I think we built one extra one. Well, that's unfortunate. And then we'd have to fill these wedges, but I don't really have that much black ice on me right now. Enough for 10. Well, at least 10 gets the center, I think. Now we're missing that square. Blind me did not see it. It's usually easier to do this overhaul before the benches are in place, because they block some visibility. So we are still need one wedge there, but we don't have black ice for it at the moment. Let's actually place the Yeti here just to see what it's like. Seems like another tall boy. Hello. Interesting diet. Stats are fairly horrible. Gets decent amount of health from vitality though, and has pretty decent vitality to begin with. Not sure about your armor class, however. Starts at 53. If we give you wines, you will eat them, and you will gain survival buff. What? The horse received vitality from those. Okay, interesting. And have some plant fibers on me. So will those provide a strength buff? No. You get different things from what the other gains. But it's not a bad option, because it gives you vitality. Mm-hmm. And next we probably want to head to the Temple of Frost, and that means we go back to the volcano to pick up our Tarman. I'd prefer if Tarman were to be able to tank the enemies there. But I will take these hardened steel swords with me. And I'm not sure what the other items were. We were supposed to use a hardened steel base for it. I think pickaxe was one of them, but we don't have the hardened steel bar for it at the moment. Just spent most of our insulated wood upgrading this base, so we'll leave you crafting steel reinforcements. Let's see if 300 is enough. And the frost shot on you. I'm fairly sure I had a hardened steel pick here somewhere, but maybe it's in the Cimmerian area. We might want to pick it up just for the black ice recipe. Also, was it only black ice that they required to be crafted? I don't really remember. Yeah, the Frost Temple can be agonizing the first time you go there. It's a very cold location, so if you don't have a good cold temperature resistance, then you're going to have a bit of a hard time there. Although it's only in the central area where you'll be plagued by that. When you go past it, you might actually get some protection from the shelter in there. Yeah, I don't think I need anything from this location for Temple of Winter. Oh, you decided to follow me away from the cliff that you were standing on. So yeah, frost giants can be rather nasty. They don't really deal too much damage per hit, but the chilling effect that their attack has on you is the dangerous part about it. I've had some success in fighting against them horseback, because it allows you to ignore their knockdowns, and when they hit you, the damage gets shared between your mount and yourself, I think. Maybe. But even then, I use the best cold resistant armor in the game to basically tank them. The trick was to kill them before they had a chance to really hit you that many times. And where the hell is... There you are. Don't leave your carried gear here, because we'll be bringing back a lot of black ice from that temple. Going to need a torch for warmth. I think I might also have some food that produces heat, except if I don't. Well, we can usually loot some from the frost giants. Let's equip eye shot arrow and pull aggro from that giant there, so our follower will also get interested in aggroing. And he'll pull aggro from one of them. So yeah, frostbitten by taking a few hits. We got some spice food. But even then, we're still taking shitloads of damage over time from that cold debuff. And that's in a area where we are only cold by default. When we go in and there's areas where we are extremely cold, even with this armor on, you really want to avoid taking hits and have the follower tank for us. Is it just standing still there? Oh, absinthe and gold dust. And where's the body of the other giant? Did it fall down? because I'm not seeing it here. But it is returned to that location and it's still alive. Yeah, that's what happened. Rhino heads up for increased carrying capacity. And we are taking environmental damage from this main hall. Can't really do much about it. Need the spiced haunches. Yeah, we have shelter in this area, so we have some temperature resistance here. But we'll still pull some aggro, I guess. Yeah, this is now less than ideal. Well, the loot is very good. Actually, do I get full shelter if I stand near a wall? Yeah, that's even better. And this is where the forge is. I think it has four giants in that room, maybe. At least three. But it's not where we want it to be just yet. I always get confused by these routes here. I think this leads to the boss. And we get soothing temperature here. This is not as cold. But we were unable to dodge mid animation. You'll dance for me now. Right. And this should be where the boss is. Hrygnir of the Frost. He's there by himself, but he's surrounded by two additional giants on each side that you cannot really see from the entrance. You can see that axe. That axe. So possibly looking at a group fight against enemies whose hits you don't really want to take because it comes with chilling component. But I guess we can maybe pull aggro with a bow. So now Tarman will butcher that guy. Also, I'm not sure if he'll maintain aggro and beeline towards the next one. Try. And you can use that shield, I'm just not sure if it'll make you less offensive, because if you equip the shield, it might mean that you just want to stay still and get hit. But we'll see. And I pretty can't cripple that guy. Seems to have a special hit of sorts. Also, he's now a bit broken. But should be still be easier to kill than the world bosses. I don't think you get any good loot from that guy. The real treasure is this steel here. Gives you the feed for black eyes stuff. There's only one chest. There's also his throne, but you can't climb it. Yeah, a bit underwhelming area. If you have a companion with you, that is. And this entrance here leads to a room which, at least before, didn't really have a purpose. There are a few giants there and something that looked like a magical phenomenon, but it didn't do anything. I think there's also a chest there. But yeah, the temple has a lot of black ice inside it. Fight might be slightly rougher. Also, you might be able to exploit it by heading to a location such as this. Maybe they won't be able to close up on you. So you'll just blink them from afar and maybe hope for the best. Now taken. But we managed to fuck up our follower by doing that, I think. Here it's not as cold. Yeah, I feel like the shield has really fucked his battle tactics. He's not really hitting. He's just waiting to be hit. Let's take the way. We have a respawn as well. Great. Just what I needed. I think this giant is the one who's next to the forge. He's got slightly more hit points than the other ones, I think. Where's one of the bodies? Is this one here? Yeah. This is the forge of Ymir. And you can make the black ice crafts here if you have the materials for them. Fortunately, we have. And the black ice that you should have. Right. This is also where you craft the Bride of Aesir that you've yet to unlock. And both of these are one-handed swords with same combat animations. The other one is way more powerful than the other, I just can't remember which one it was. You can also turn hardened steel throwing axes and javelins into their black ice versions. Which sounds expensive, because there's ammunition, but I don't know, it's only black ice and time. And if they cause the cold snap in PvP against other players, then they might be useful in certain circumstances. The black ice pick is probably as good as the Acheronian pick that we are using, except repairing it takes black ice, I think. It's otherwise pretty much the same. I might be wrong, but I don't think I am in this case. The bad thing about this smithy is that you cannot, as far as I know, attach a blacksmith into this because it has no space for it, so you don't get the discount to the Bride of Aesir when you craft it here. It takes the full crafting cost, which might make it more expensive than your other similar items. But a good haul so far. Rhino head soups and absinthe and of course these are why we came here for. And the next journey step that we unlocked by defeating the Hrygnir of the Frost is to discover all the giant king obelisks. Which I think is more difficult than to discover all the Lemurian lore stones. Because the lore stones are mainly here in the north, whereas the giant king obelisks are all over the place. And at some point people have even wondered if they those journey steps can glitch out and prevent you from completing them if you do them in the wrong order or something. I've never completed them myself, so I wouldn't know. Yeah, the broadswords got 90 points higher damage than the longsword. So it makes it a very powerful one-handed sword with that kind of damage and PvP effect from the black ice, causing debuff, I think, unless it's only present in the longsword, which would explain why its damage is so much lower. Weight 7, durability 425. So it's heavier. It's hard to say about the durability, I think this is 500 total, maybe. We lose 25% by attaching an upgrade. So that would bring it down to 375, maybe. And this is just below the halfway point, so maybe this is 350 when fully repaired. Yeah, I think the Acheronian pick might be slightly better, but Acheronian pick takes hardened steel bars to repair. This one takes black ice, and the black ice is easier to get because hardened steel requires black ice to make. So there's that. In earlier versions, hardened steel parts just took steel and brimstone, but they changed the brimstone into black ice. Because of reasons. Not sure what those reasons are. But it basically prevented hardened steel from being a thing in the southern areas, where you could get brimstone previously. So yeah, if you don't have the glacier crack from the religion of Ymir, it is basically the way to get the black ice weapon achievement. Journey step, whichever term you prefer to use. And we'll leave this sword here. We'll harvest some black ice on our way back, because I'm going to need some of it for base upgrades, but
you've got no chance, baby. Use that to face it. Do your swing for me later.
Got more absinthe and another shield that we might take, but not actually need. Let's actually use the pick that we just got to mine up this black ice. We'll be able to see if repairing only takes black ice for it. So we get 10 or 12 resource when we use this pick without upgrade. So that means 7 or 8 without the upgrade with base values. So this is harvest level 7, I guess. As maybe is our Acheronian pick. Basically freezing our balls off. Shelter here, but I think it's this staircase that's warmer. Yeah, goes to cold. So if we eat this hunch of meat, we could get to soothing maybe. Unless the black ice pick causes us to lose our temperature, which it does not seem to do. I need more black ice to repair it. So let's see, repair. Okay, I was wrong. It also takes hardened steel bars. So maybe it's not really worth using unless you're not level 60 quite yet. when you have the opportunity to get it. And now we'll just run outside. We don't really have a good reason to stay and fight. Also, the giants are probably... Well, they gave up. I thought they'd be slightly faster than the normal NPCs in moving and might be able to give a chase, but they decided not to. And while we are here, you might want to keep an eye out for meteor crashes. We didn't hear the sounds, but we were in the area for a extended period of time, so maybe some meteors did land. Where the hell is my water skin now?